dusk in rural Zambia. Once it meant the wind down of the day, but with electricity, life goes on. Damian got power a year and a half ago and says it's been transformational. Getting electricity to towns as remote as this is an expensive engineering challenge. Follow the pylons and it brings you here, Zengamina Hydro Power Plant. This is a so-called mini-grid, an island of power generation, and it has a not-so-secret weapon, Bitcoin. Since 2013, this container full of powerful computers has been whirring away in the Zambian bush 24/7, earning Bitcoin, the most valuable virtual currency.
These are the actual miners. They're not very sexy, but they do their job. All a miner needs is a power cord and an internet connection. It starts mining.
How many are in right now?
There's about 120 in here right now.
It's an odd place for a high-tech crypto operation, but it makes sense for the company that installed it and runs it in partnership with the energy firm because of the electricity being so cheap.
It's very noisy, but it's a beautiful noise. Because the truth is, this noise means we're making money.
In Bitcoin, there are no banks or financial institutions, so every transaction needs to be checked and verified and added to the public list of payments by Bitcoin mining computers. As an incentive, this network of volunteer miners is rewarded with new coins. At the moment, the mine here earns about $5 in Bitcoin per day per machine. But with all that number crunching, wear and tear is an issue. Engineers like Kevin have set up a computer repair workshop in the bush.
It is a chipboard. It contains the chips, and the chips are very, very, important.
It's inside these chips that these crazy calculations are being done.
Yeah,
it allows you to get the Bitcoin.
Of course, some are going to have issues. Yeah, based on the power they're consuming, based on the environment they're in.
Kevin's Kenya-based company Gridless has six sites like this in three different countries across Africa. It's a lot of travel to remote areas, but it's worth it for cheap renewable energy. And for energy makers like Zengamina Hydro, which opened in 2007, it's also been hugely beneficial because of a problem known as stranded power.
We really struggled to make ends meet, and every day we were wasting over 50% of the energy that we could generate, which also meant we're not earning from that. What we lacked was an institutional, a major user of power in the area, and that's where the game-changing partnership with Gridless came in, because their unique model where they can take excess power flexibly to create value through the computing power has transformed our operations. And the extra revenue, important to say, has also helped us keep the prices down for what we charge the local people, which is also very important.
Daniel insists that the hydro plant's priority remains serving electricity to the locals, but adoption has been slow, with few heavy users like factories in the area. Around 30% of the plant's revenue now comes from the Bitcoin mine.
Bitcoin mining didn't build Zengamina Hydro Plant, but there's no doubt it's been a win, not just for the energy company and the Bitcoin miners, but also for the local town. However, the plant has received a huge amount of investment and will soon be expanding. They hope to sell any excess energy eventually back to the grid. So Philip and team have got to hit the road and find a new place as perfect as this.
As well as searching for sites with excess energy, Gridless is now hoping to start building its own mini-grid energy plants, with its Bitcoin mine as the first major tenant.
I'm sure you'll have critics who will worry that the community want the energy, but you'll favour the mining. How can you assure that that won't happen?
So it's a really good question, and you're right, we get asked that a lot. The truth is that Bitcoin mining doesn't pay very high prices for electricity. If we think of ourselves less as a Bitcoin miner and more as an energy producer, then Bitcoin becomes one buyer that has a price they're willing to pay. The community is another buyer that will pay a higher price. Our economic interest is to sell to the higher paying customer, and that's always going to be the community.
The mission to get electricity to isolated communities is a monumental task in Africa. A 2022 estimate from the International Energy Agency suggests 600 million people on the continent are without power. But because of Bitcoin's reputation, some companies and authorities remain uncomfortable with including it in electrification projects. These are the kind of operations that dominate crypto mining. Globally, the industry is estimated to use as much energy as a small country like Poland. The environmental impact has long been a concern too, but according to analysts, there are signs that could be improving, with more of the mining giants moving to sustainable energy mixes instead of just fossil fuels. But setups like Zengamina have none of these problems. Yes, they're a tiny part of the overall mining picture, but they're also a rare example of a controversial industry creating much more than just digital coins.